Have you ever felt like you're stuck on pause and life is still going around you? Do you feel that your situation will never change and there's no way out? Do you want to change your circumstances and chase those dreams that you have always had? Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the show. I'm SYLBOURNE SHOW, and of course, I was reading an excerpt on the back of Open Doors with my guest, Miss Tarnya Coley.
Hi.
Tarnya, how are you doing
today? I'm good, how are you?
I'm cool in the Malibu.
I was waiting for that. So am I, I'm cool.
Do you understand when I say cool?
No, yeah, I'm chilled.
You're chilled? Yeah. Are you drinking?
I don't drink.
You don't
water.
Drink?
Water.
Okay, okay. You think people are watching now and say, she drink, man, she drink. Listen, well, thank you for coming on the show today, Tarnya.
Thank you for having me.
And ladies and gentlemen, what we're talking about is Open Doors. An inspirational true story, my life, my journey. I always find it fascinating, you know, books, you know, because I'm being piled up with lots of books now. Some of them I'm trying to read, some of them, but it's so important because books capture a moment in time.
Yeah.
And books transcend ages and generations upon generations, because I tell you this, some of the books which we're reading today were books written by persons who were just like, yeah, just write this book, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
You know? So tell us about Open Doors, Tarnya.
Okay, so Open Doors, as you said, it's my journey, my life, and it starts from when my mom had me in the 70s. Yeah. She was 16, and it all starts from there, and it's quite dramatic with my mom's story. And then when she told the baby father, he didn't want to know.
Yes.
So that was quite dramatic for her, being 16 and alone. And I start from that point because I look at my mom and how she actually went through her journey being a single parent with no support. And then myself growing up without a father figure. So lots of things stemmed from that, the rejection, the low self-esteem, the lack of confidence. And then I talk about those pain points, which I think a lot of people can identify with.
Yes.
And then I look at my journey and how I came to a point where I thought enough was enough. Yeah. I need to become more and do more. And then look at how I did that. And that's what I talk about in my book.
Yeah. I tell you what I find with the story when it started off, when your mother, when she had to leave, and then she had to go to her boyfriend. And I could picture it.
Yeah,
and that's, you know, that's the beauty of it. I could actually I saw it,
you know,
I saw it happening in a way which was really good and captivating, and I believe that is one of the exciting things about hearing dropping off as well.
Yes. I tried to style that one out.
The good thing about the show is that anything may happen. My time might just drop off or something. And it's an open heaven.
Yeah, you know? It is. You
know? Yeah. So that sort of story there, it is not just your story, it's a lot of people's story, isn't it, Tarnya?
Yeah, it is about my mom's story. And what's so important about that story, she's 16 and alone, and a lot of people can identify with that. And what I find really interesting is my daughter's now 16, and I can imagine my daughter coming home and telling me she's pregnant. Could I do what happened to my mom, you know, right, you need to leave home. You need to go. I think it would be a different story.
Yes,
and I think it's important to start from that point, because when you understand my mom's journey and then you look at my journey, it's quite similar in where she had a lot of struggles, but she overcame them.
Yes.
I've gone through my struggles and I'm still on my journey. We're all still on our journey. Yeah. And that's what I want to encourage people to know, that yes, you go through certain things, but then it's how you overcome that. And that's what I talk about in the book, about how to overcome.
Overcome. Now, talking about, it's from a youth perspective at the same time, because in today's world and with lots of young people, they're also going through these moments. You know, fortunately, you are of the understanding that if that happens, you know, you're not going to do the same thing.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
But then what's the message out there for other people now, those who are maybe about to experience that? What happened to your mom? What's the message to them then? Being kicked out.
Yeah, so the message is, we're not always going to have the perfect story. Things are going to happen. And I know sometimes it can be very tragic what happens, but we have to learn through that. And it's about reaching out to other people and finding that support network. And I think throughout the book, it is talking about communicating, ensuring that you do communicate what's going on, because that support network can be helpful. It may not be your family, it may be professionals, maybe somebody else, but reach out. That's so important, to reach out.
And being an author, is that a rewarding rewarding journey?
Being an author, I've not really sat and really reflected about it. I've just, for me, I've just wrote my story. And just to empower and encourage other people to know my journey, what I've gone through and how you can overcome, and then telling other people. So I've not really had an opportunity to really sit and reflect. Whoa, I'm an author. No.
It's the first book.
It's my first book.
Yes, first book.
Yeah.
And it's released?
It was out May the 1st. Yeah.
May the 1st?
You know, I wrote that in 6 weeks.
In 6 weeks?
Mm.
Wow, wow.
January the 1st, I started this year.
So the book was, but before you wrote it, the book was already in you.
Yes.
And when was the point whereby, and this is for persons out there who may be considering writing a book, when was that point where you decided you got to get it out?
You know, I get that question a lot. And for me, it's quite interesting, because for years, I've been told, write your story because of what you've gone through. And I thought, I didn't have the confidence to write it. Who's going to read it? Who's going to be really interested? Because then I thought, okay, I'll do it. But this was 15 years later, I decided I was going to do it, because I was in church and my pastor, Pastor Paul Lloyd from Victory Outreach in Salford, he talked about, he's preached a message about owning your future.
Yes.
And I thought, am I owning my future? I'm a lecturer. And I've been doing that for 15 years. I do what I do. I, you know, I help students do things, etc. Yeah, I kind of am doing what I think I'm called to do. But I think there was more for me to do. And the book came back to me. Why don't you write your story and empower other people? And I thought, okay, that was the end of last year. And I thought, 1st of January 2018, I'm going to do it. And then I just thought, just go for it.
Yes.
And I did.
So what, did you lock off for 6 weeks in the room?
Can you imagine? That'd be nice.
If it was olden days, you'd have to have a
the typewriter
and then flip up that one. But it's a bit different.
It's slightly different now. We've moved forward a little bit. So what I did, because I was still lecturing, I've got two children, 16 and 12. Yes. My husband, we've married for 18 years. And so I've still got my life, still got my church life and everything like that. But I decided I'm going to make a commitment just for a season of my life. I'm going to get up 5 o'clock every morning.
Good. Yeah.
I'm going to write. Then I'm going to go to work, do what I do, and then come home. And then when the kids are gone to bed, I'm going to do more writing.
Yes.
And I did that consistently for 6 weeks.
Well, you see, what I'm doing is giving your secrets out there.
You know? You are?
Yes. I just gave you a secret out there. You know, the person, because a lot of people, you know, are actually like at that threshold there, because a lot of persons are book publishers. And of course, Marcia M Publish House, you know, they are encouraging people to write. And lots of things people always say, where do I find the time? You know, but I said something the other day, and it's on my page. I don't know if you saw it. It's a video I did. Person keeps saying, I can't find the time. I can't find the time. And I said, if you don't find the time for yourself, you're going to be someone else. Or something.
It's true. It's true. And it is about creating. If you find something that you love to do, you're going to create the time.
Now, this is important, because you're going straight into my video now. I'm talking about you. How can you create time out of 24 hours, which is always there?
That's very good. My mum always said there is enough time in a day for you to do what you need to do. But it's about prioritising.
My days. I think, were we talking before I did that video? You need to watch it. Ladies and gentlemen, you need to watch that video there. No, seriously.
It is. You have to prioritise, because not everything is important. Not everything is urgent. So what I do a to-do list. What's important? What do I need to do? And I knew that my mission was to write my book. So I made sure I got up at 5 o'clock. It wasn't easy. Oh, I'm going to get up and write a book. I did it, and I was consistent. It's only for a season. It's not going to be forever. That's what people need to realize. If it's important to you, you're going to create the time to do it.
You know, people sometimes who are studying and they said, I need to do that degree or I need to do that course. They say, oh, I don't have that time for 3 years to do it. And you know what happened? 3 years gone. And they keep saying, oh man, I should have done that 3 years ago. But should have us do it now, isn't it?
It's about the urgency, it's doing it now.
Yeah. Tell us about more of yourself.
Oh, me? Oh.
Yes. You see, people buy people. They want to buy the book.
They want to know the person behind the book. So, as I said, I was a lecturer for 15 years.
Are you still lecturing?
I'm going to tell you why I'm not doing it anymore.
No, when I say lecturing people, talking to people.
Yeah. My daughter always talks to me about I'm always lecturing.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
So I went to university, graduated as a teacher, and I did my degree and then did an extra year to do my teaching. And I've been doing that for 15 years. Absolutely love what I do. Mm. Teaching students, empowering them. And not only do I get them to get through a qualification and graduate, but what I really enjoy is actually imparting in them personally, in their personal development, I really enjoy doing. So I've been doing that for 15 years. And I reflected and I thought, okay, there's something more that I want to do. There's extra things that I want to do, but I'm not able to do that whilst I'm doing the lecturing. Yeah. And plus, teaching is not what it used to be. It's not you just don't go in and teach anymore. There's much more things that you have to do alongside
just follow, that. Follow process and...
And I didn't have a quality of life and I didn't have that work-life balance.
Yeah.
And I thought, I want to do my own things now. Mm. And there comes a point where I thought, enough is enough.
Yes.
So I handed in my notice in April this year. You have to give 3 months' notice, and I did that. Mm. And I just did what I want to do.
Just walk.
Yeah.
And doing what you love.
Do what I love. I'm writing my second book. Oh, I've wrote my second book. I do workshops on transforming yourself for success.
Yes.
I've written a personal development program, which is a 6-week online course. Mm. And I've got clients now on that. And they're now doing that. So, yeah, I love doing that.
So you're like a transformational coach?
I'm a personal development coach, yeah.
Awesome. Mm. Awesome. Now, what do you think about this then with the influx of many coaches out there and many people are digging into persons' lives and opening them up and leaving them?
No, that's not what I do.
Yeah.
It's that's so important that you've got to be actually interested in doing that.
Yes.
And what I like is, telling people why we do things, but I like to show them how you can do it. Because people always say to me, I want to do X, Y, and Z, but how do I do that? So why, on my program, I actually walk you through step by step on how to do what you want to do.
Yes.
And that's what it's about.
Because I notice you've got all these different steps.
Yes.
And which is like it's like a workbook, key to leading a motivated life, you know? I need you to do one of my series, the Don't Go With The Flow series, you know, whereby you end it by saying, and remember, don't go with the flow, you know.
Dare create your own path.
Yeah, create your own path, you know. Dare to dream. I always say this, and this is what I say. Let's fire off some quote now, because I say, the sky is not the limit.
Yes.
The sky is the start.
Oh, come on now.
Give me yours.
Feel the fear and do it anyway.
Oh, my days, you know. And I'm going to hit you another one. Don't go with the flow, or you'll be in someone else's stream.
Ooh.
Create your own rivers.
I like that. Nothing grows in comfort zones.
Oh my goodness. Ladies and gentlemen, this is going crazy, man. But listen, dare to dream big. Key two, talk about reflection. Beware of hindrances. Stay focused and stay in zone. Perspective. So the book is not just about, it's about your life and your background and your story, but also you are giving tools of success.
And that's what my book number two does.
Yeah. Wow.
It's a 365, The Simple Way to Get Motivated.
Oh, wow.
So each day you read a verse and to inspire yourself and then motivate yourself and others. So that's what my next book will be out next year, looking at that.
So how can people get your book, The Open Door?
So Open Doors is available on Amazon. Mm-hmm. But if you want a personalised signed copy from myself, you can go on my website and order that. And then postage and packaging is free and I will post that to you.
And your publishing house is Marcia M.
Marcia M. Publishing
Fantastic.
House.
She seems like she has a lot of babies there.
Has a lot of babies. And they've been birthed.
They've been birthed.
Yes.
And that is really powerful, you know?
Yeah.
But before you go, and of course we put the subtitles and the details of the website down there for persons to actually get it. And my personal signed copy is very expensive. You can buy that, of course, you know. Now, we just fired off four quotes a while ago, motivational.
Yeah.
Thing. And man, I could go on. I think I'm going to do a show when I was...
Just
fly it off.
Just fire them out.
Fire off the persons, you know. What is your favorite quote or mantra that you'd want to share with someone now? If I was looking at that camera there with an explanation, you know, because we always have something. Like mine is, don't go with the flow.
Yeah, yeah.
You know,
I like that one.
I love that one, you know. What would you say?
Mine would be plan it, see it, and anticipate it. Because it is about planning things.
Yes.
You have to plan what you want to do.
Yes.
Because sometimes, someone said to me, it's like, if you don't have a goal, it's like going to the airport without a ticket.
Yes.
You have to have a plan. you write it down and make it clear, yes. and then you see it, you start to visualize where you are going,
yes.
and then you anticipate it, you believe it's going to happen,
yes.
and you do it,
yes.
and just go for it, and that's mine.
Wow,
yeah.
wow. Ladies and gentlemen, that's powerful, and that's a wrap. Tarnya Coley. And ladies and gentlemen, it is Tarnya.
Yeah, T-A-R-N-Y-A.
I make sure, because it's so easy one to say Tarnya. Now, ladies and gentlemen, I want to thank you so much for joining. Now, as you can see, the book is called The Open Doors by Tarnya Coley, the first of the trilogy. Sorry, I said trilogy. I just give it more than... I know there's one more, but there's much more which is in the making. It is so good when persons actually, after years of working or whatever, they come to the full fruition of what they're about. But I always say this, never underestimate those times when you are going through
yeah.
those even wilderness moments, because they're actually training ground, because she wouldn't be where she is unless she didn't have that story, you know? So therefore, what I want to say is this, there are open doors which are out there, but before you can get the open door, you got to go in and actually do the work and kick down some other doors first. And after a while, there's a massive open door. That's my foreword, which should have been in this book. But next time...
Maybe the next one.
Maybe in the next one. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Any last word you want to say?
Well, if you have a dream...
Yes.
...and you really, really want to go for it...
Yes.
...feel the fear...
Yes.
...and do it anyway.
Wow, wow. Right. Feel the fear and do it anyway. And climb the highest mountains, because guess what? It is just a mountain. Man, I just created that one. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for coming on the SYLBOURNE Show. And of course, thank you so much for coming. Yes, thank you all for being on the show with me, of course, because it takes two and three or four or five to tango. Remember to like and subscribe to the SYLBOURNE Show, and follow me on Instagram, YouTube. And of course, to find out more about Tarnya Coley, you can see it on the website, which we'll be putting up very shortly. And as well, you can see it on the website and our website, which is there. Thank you so much and have a good day. Awesome. Hey, that was great. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for joining us on the SYLBOURNE Show, and of course what I'd like you to do is to like the videos, share the videos, and subscribe to the channel. Let people know about it, but the important thing is also to comment. Let us get your comment, let us get your views, so we can understand how to even please you better, ladies and gentlemen. So as I said, share, like, subscribe. Ah, thank you, I saw you there. You subscribe and you shared. Thank you so much. See you next time. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for joining us on the SYLBOURNE Show. And of course, what I'd like you to do is to like the videos, share the videos, and subscribe to the channel. Let people know about it. But important thing is also to comment. Let us get your comment, let us get your views, so we can understand how to even please you better, ladies and gentlemen. So as I said, share, like, subscribe. Ah, thank you. I saw you there. You subscribe and you shared. Thank you so much. See you next time.